Hi, my name is Robert Easter with American Industrial Brands. I want to tell you a little bit about American Industrial and a unique opportunity to invest in American manufacturing. American Industrial has three different types of manufacturing processes in acrylics, plastics, and porcelain products that have become increasingly expensive and unavailable from China as COVID has made that much more challenging. However, it's been a trend for some. Most of these types of products since the 1970s have been outsourced to Mexico and China for labor cost reasons. These types of facilities, there's a very high capital investment for new facilities. And we can talk a little bit about that. We are in a unique position that we found something that is very cost effective and to restart. We also have a problem with your operating management is most of that operational knowledge, because of the many years of outsourcing, have been lost in the U.S., where there's been a much higher concentration of tech-style jobs. Your plants now have to be more technology-based. And then they require the types of products we do are required for every home and business in the U.S., and especially since updates in code listing and water efficiency, those things don't go out of style. So we've got something that is needed and doesn't really go out of style. So that's a little bit about us and who we are. Again, the problem that we're solving is that acrylics, plastics, and porcelain products have been expensive and unavailable in Asia, especially during COVID. What our solution allows us to do is our ability to provide sanitary fixtures on private label basis to major big box retail. That is huge. And the reason for that is these things, again, they're in every home. They're big demand, especially as you do renovations or new construction. We've already secured a supply contract with Menards, which is a pretty good name in the Midwest. And we have already had conversations as we take this factory online that you can name the big box suppliers and they've got private label that we can eventually help supply. So being US based, very quick turnarounds, experienced manufacturing team, those things are very difficult to really put into one operation at a time when these things have been offshored for so many years. Our operating cost infrastructure, it has moderate fixed costs. We've got some also besides what we call, private label solution or the OEM solution, we have legacy brands, and that's hence the name American Industrial Brands, that we also are going to be manufacturing. And we'll talk again a little bit about those things. And those have quite a bit of value in the marketplace. So in these types of products, you don't have to explain who you are, because many of the products we compete with are literally 100 years old plus, including some of our legacy brand names. So that's very important. And then people within the plumbing industry, as mentioned, obviously are seeking American-made products for installation and distribution for a number of different reasons, some government contracting, but just more than anything, the products that are made here generally are made with a high level of quality. So those things are still intrinsic in the value in the minds of our customers. Our accomplishments to date, if you'll notice, you'll see some robotics and you'll see some products that are actually in our factory in Kokomo, Indiana. One of the big hurdles in doing a factory like this that is predominantly, it's almost entirely robotic in the process of making these especially sanitary ware and acrylics, what you find is that your speed of efficiencies are really improved upon identifying proper raw material and material formulations, simply because you get a consistency and you get a quality, and you don't have an issue with the waste and things that you've got to literally throw away after you made them. And And so that lowers cost, and it also gives us a very confident ability to predict what our production is going to be, what we can deliver. And those things are super important to our customers. You just can't really mess this up in a way that you don't deliver. That has been probably our greatest opportunity has been the recent year and a half of COVID has caused a lot of interruption in the supply chain. And so this factory will shore quite a bit of that. And we have a lot of folks in the industry that are excited about what we're doing. We've identified all of our equipment needs. Most of it is installed and in operating. Again, we've improved upon our casting process. I'll give you an example. Our casting process, the first time that we were able to be successful with that, took us for the bottom section of the sanitary ware, it's called the bowl, which is basically for sanitary explanations. It's what you sit on if you go to the restroom. That took 32 minutes per press to press one bowl out. And of course you've got multiple machines and robots and casting cells. However, in getting our raw materials identified, we were able to reduce that and cut that in half. We've actually improved upon it to where we're now down to 12 minutes per casting process. That means in the same period of time, you literally get three for one. The old analogy, you know, farmers improve their plants because they can grow more in less space. It's the same process in manufacturing. And so those things are very challenging. They take some time. They take a lot of really smart engineers to get to that point in process, but we're there, and that's why we're completing the full production setup, and we will start producing next year to our customers right out of Kokomo. So we have got a very detailed production process and plan. We have confirmed market conditions that we can sell what we make. We've also secured upfront contracts that, you know, again, I mentioned Menards. However, we're in talks with some others, and we feel very confident with the legacy brands and the things that we can bring in house that this factory, by the time it is for full production, will be completely pre-sold. So that is very strong for a business plan. It's something that we're proud of, and we've worked hard to be in that position. Again, the other thing that's really important with one of these types of businesses is because the new moving parts and the employment and the scheduling and the supply relationships, we've got our managing partner, Briggs, has got established business processes, quickly ramp up the business for payroll, insurance, purchasing, and that sort of thing. So, you know, our credit is outstanding with our supply chain, our supplier, our vendors. Those things take some time as well. We've got years of those kind of relationships. And to run one of these factories, you better have those in place. Most entrepreneurs probably wouldn't just jump into a project like this simply because there are so many unknowns and things that you have to have in place, and you have to have experience. And that's something that we come to the table with. As far as our ownership, all of the funding to date has been completed by the partners and there's just a handful that originally founded the facility, purchased the facility in Kokomo. It was originally purchased under Coast OEM. And again, we have had some additional opportunities for both bettering the business plan and acquiring some other product lines and types of products that work well with the the sanitary solutions that we are capable of selling and marketing and working within the industry of, you know, kitchen bath products. All of our sources of funding, again, have come from our own group, and we do not have debt on this business. The only type of debt that we are looking at this point in time would be completing out either the EB-5, which would obviously be an equity investment, or another capital round that would probably be more of a commercial line of credit. And that is essentially a startup. So we've purchased the building in 2018. We've done a bridge capital loan for some of the development of what we have just discussed inside the facility. especially the robotics and setting up some of the processes, proving out the business plan. And then we've done a recent capital round just a few months back to get us kind of over the hump. And then we are really, the train's left the station. We're working on getting the factory to maximum production capacity simply because we're at that point in time. The project cost, again, you know, we've got a project that at $25 million, that's about $85 a square foot total turnkey development and operation. The average for something like this is about $200 a square foot. And there's plenty of reasons why we've really taken our time to look at doing something like this, because coming out of the ground on something this sizable is an expensive project, but because of our knowledge and what we know about the industry and this business, and being able to run this business is a distinct advantage, and have a plan. Our big hiring, if you'll look, and I'll point out, is the production of vitreous, which is the sanitary. This is where we spent most of our time, and that's the Kokomo plant. And those are literally four robotic operators. And basically, they are in a station. We have, you know, that cover 24 hours a day. And so what we will start doing in quarter three, and we may push this to quarter four, is we will start training those people. We actually have some information and videos of some of that machinery actually in process and working. And so we have a training program. We have to get them ready. That's our big push. Then we will start filling out what we call the corporate operating management team in Kokomo. We have several selected that will join the Kokomo team that are already working with us, that we've hand selected, that have been in this type of industry. You know, let me give you one example. Nick Quattro, our CFO, he is right now working at Goose Creek, South Carolina. He is the Brig CFO. He is the only CFO I know, other than my competitors, that actually have factories in the like Kohler or Mansfield, that has actually run one of these factories. He's had a very large factory in Texas some years back, probably about 12 years ago. They shut that factory down. Again, it was one of the casualties of offshoring, but he understands the mechanics of and the detail it takes to actually operate one of these. And he is a huge treasure for our management team. But again, we will add production molding, which is the injection molding. We have inject products those are the little parts that go inside the valves. One of our brand names, Coast, we own all of the proprietary tooling and molding. And so that part of the business, you know, is just literally just supplying what we're already making with China. And then, of course, we've got maintenance people. Maintenance hires are very important, because you got to keep, you know, all of our manufacturing running. You got to keep the lights on. We have heavy power in the building. Again, that heavy power has to be maintained. There's quite a bit of maintenance. And so that's a maintenance staff. The sales staff really doesn't come in until 2022. Again, they are more customer relation people. They will literally just take care of, you know, interfacing, making sure the orders are on time, making sure we've got proper inventory pickups of logistics. If we do import some supplementary products that we can also ship with the sanitary, they simply manage that process. And then we do have a marketing model that is literally our branding of every available in-house brand, again, hence American Industrial Brands. We haven't talked about those things, but we've got some really neat ones. So that, you can see quarter three and quarter four of 2021, that's where we are. We're into this model where we have to start hiring. We have to put, you know, team leadership in place. We have to make sure that all of our equipment has properly trained individuals, since it is robotic. This, again, is not a big, you know, manual labor type of plant. And so it is very focused on predictable outcomes with our production. So the job creation is, if we don't create these jobs, we can't run the building. That's as simple as I can make it. As far as the administration, supervisors, assemblers, and the Little Rock facility, those have already been hired. We will increase that headcount probably in 2022. We are actually rebuilding some of the manufacturing processes as we speak. That produces jetted tubs and shower pans that go into, you know, bathrooms. A little bit about that factory. It was the last factory of the Jacuzzi family. Most people know what the Jacuzzi name is, but they actually had a business that still worked in this in jetted solutions. We've got some wonderful jetted solutions, things that really help health and wellness and beauty and all of the things that people really aspire to have in their bathrooms. And we've got a neat team there. We actually have Paulo Jacuzzi, who is head of our sales and marketing for that division. So that's the job creation. Again, as a summary, we've got single census TEA designated facility. We've got two fully integrated modern facilities currently that have been updated, have gone through that process. The money's been spent. We've got experienced, well-respected operating team. I didn't get into a lot of that simply because there's a lot there and I wanted to hit the high points. Industry-recognized brands. Again, our brands are Briggs, which is a 100-plus-year-old brand, Abington, Case, Coast, Stephen A. Young or Seiko, and Jason. And all of those have different product categories that are well known inside the industry. And again, those will continue to be produced and marketed, and sometimes they're imported. And then we, you know, obviously put our names on them or we spec out how we want those built. But our goal is literally over the next 5 to 7 years is to build everything here in the States with modern robotics. We've got a dispersed and experienced workforce that has worked in this industry. They're top people and they really understand what we're doing and what we're about. Exceptional centrally located logistics. I'm going to show you a map here real quickly. We've got direct investment opportunity, which is, you know, it's not easy to do these kinds of direct investments for EB-5, but we are direct. We're going to be the job creator. You know, we're going to create the job. We put our own money into this. And so, and we're excited. It's a great story. It's something that people, I think, get excited when they talk about it. And again, they're manufacturing jobs. They really impact the community because those dollars stay there. We have to hire in a radius that's probably less than 20, 25 miles of Kokomo, Indiana, north of Indianapolis. And we've got a lot of opportunity to also hire young and also create even a more diverse workforce. Lastly, I do have a map of our locations. The last slide there, the furthest north pin is the Kokomo, Indiana plant. That's the one that is coming online by mid-2022. And then the Knoxville plant right now is a distribution center. That was the old Briggs bathtub factory. It was one of the largest in the world until it was actually, they ceased that operation in 2011 and it has worked as a distribution hub, and it's a really good one. It's large and we can bring in imports and eventually we will retool that facility for another sanitary facility down the road. The southernmost blue pin is Charleston, South Carolina. That's our port and one of our distribution warehouses is there, and our administrative offices currently are housed there. And then the red pin is our bathtub facility, our jetted health and beauty bathtub facility. And one of the common themes about where we've located with this geographic location is literally what we call east or centralized on the Mississippi River. There's good reasons for that in manufacturing. You've got a larger population east of Mississippi. It's more difficult to import what we call freight intensive type of products that we build. And so when you can supply those quickly to a larger population, that just means you have more opportunity for sales and being able to meet customers' needs. So a little bit about that is very important to our business plan overall. And we'll probably stay concentrated literally along this for the foreseeable future because it's a winning formula. So with that, I think I've covered a lot, and I think we'll wrap that up, guys.